Hey, Mahari here, and in this video I'm going to talk a little bit about borderline personality disorder and understanding. I'm talking about understanding, but I'm not just talking about understanding borderline personality disorder from, you know, either side of the fence that you're on in terms of understanding it, like the quest for knowledge, you know, to understand, you know, what causes certain things and those with BPD. But also, there's this quest, if you will, this journey, this often really painful hook to staying involved in situations in ways that aren't healthy, and staying in relational dynamics that need change for the better, for you know, a healthier situation, but still kind of repeating old patterns, whether you have BPD or not. What's that about? What am I saying that for? Well, it ties into the topic or the subject area of understanding borderline personality disorder, and understanding, because a lot of people on both sides of the borderline personality disorder now, remember, are really, really questing hard, investing a lot of time and emotional energy into trying to be understood. And I'm wondering, you know, how is it that people set out to be understood when often they themselves don't understand? So people with borderline personality disorder have what I would refer to as a compromised awareness, until unless they get enough treatment and therapy that's successful so that they gain more awareness. For people with borderline personality disorder, feeling not understood or not being understood often is an experience as like invalidation, rejection, and even abandonment. And that can be puzzling, you know, to loved ones, family members, partners, non-borderlines, right? And non-borderlines or loved ones of those with BPD are trying to be understood too. They're like, person with borderline personality disorder is like, you know, perhaps perhaps not taking enough personal responsibility. Perhaps kind of, you know, trying to live through the other person, but doesn't know that. So, you know, is trying to meet their needs through, quote, other, unquote. And if you're that, quote, other, unquote, you're like trying to get understood, too, by the person with BPD, about what you're experiencing, what is going on for you. Trying to be understood from what is really, to the other person, a parallel universe. You know, I think that people with borderline personality disorder, until and unless they get enough treatment, and or they get on the road and into recovery and or recover, people with borderline personality disorder don't have the same frame of reference, okay, that people who don't have personality disorders have in a relational context. Well, what does that mean? It means that for the person with borderline personality disorder, a lot of what's unfolding in the here and now for the non-personality disorder person is for the borderline sort of lost to, you know, their past. And so what's unfolding in the non-borderline here and now for the non-borderline is not what the borderline is experiencing at all. You know, because most people with BPD are like often when they're triggered into dysregulated emotion, stressed out, and that kind of thing. And in relational dynamics, they're often, people with BPD are often stressed out by some facet of that relating. Because it's either triggering fear of abandonment or fear of engulfment. Because you have to remember, people with borderline personality disorder, you know, thinking all or nothing, black and white, split ways. If your love today for a person with BPD feels good to the person with BPD, they're going to feel the fear of being engulfed because they don't know who they are. So that's going to create some problems and some triggers and, you know, some issues. And the person with BPD is going to want that to be understood. And also, they may well need more understanding about that themselves. The non-personality disorder person on the other side of somebody with BPD is going to want to be understood about what they're experiencing. And often, they're just, for many people, in many forms of relationships, with people in what I call the active throes of BPD, who aren't, you know, in treatment or getting treatment or successful treatment, or who aren't, you know, taking responsibility for treatment, so that they can be on the road to learning that cognitive restructuring that's so critical and such a central part of recovery from borderline personality disorder, that then can create a bridge between these two parallel universes whereby the non-borderline and the borderline can actually start to understand each other. So the quest for understanding by the person with borderline personality disorder, if they don't feel understood, they're going to go into often, you know, the all bad devaluing split cycle, if you will, because they feel abandoned, rejected, and invalidated when they don't feel heard, validated, or understood. And the non-personality disorder person, the loved one of those BPD, you know, on the other side of this feels often misunderstood also. It's almost like two people sitting down trying to communicate and speaking two totally different languages, emotionally especially. So it's really important to think about this for a while if you haven't already, because I know that for people with borderline personality disorder, the issue of being understood or not being understood, like I said, going to invalidation, abandonment, rejection, causes a lot of reaction and a lot of emotional pain for those with BPD. Whether or not the non-borderline is rejecting them or invalidating them or anything or not, because often in the here and now it's not the case. This wanting to understand and have the person with borderline personality disorder understand you in a way that either allows for closure, if that's where the situation is at, or in a way that would allow for the person with borderline personality disorder to be the person that you want them to be. Say to both sides of borderline personality disorder, each and every one of us can't really control how somebody else perceives something. And what's underneath trying to understand, trying to be understood? Often it's trying to control things that we don't have any control over. Both the borderline and the non-borderline are being trapped in toxic relational patterns around this issue of understanding.